Anthony's part of a game, right? Anthony's involved in community radio.
I did not.
I think Johnny didn't know, and he's the first person up.
Exactly right. Johnny's up the first act, and he's just found out himself. He's got an act that's up together in 4 minutes.
Four minutes, Johnny. You and your co-star.
Because she's, we can't, I know, but we can't, if she comes out and then if she's in Humpty Dumpty, then they'll know it's Angelique, and they'll think it's Angelique and not Humpty Dumpty. It's Humpty Dumpty. It's not Angelique, it's Humpty Dumpty. Johnny and Humpty Dumpty. Okay. And then we're going to have the musical, oh yeah, the SRAM musical station is going to come and give us a little soundscape. After them, the new creation children are coming and giving us the three little pigs. I got to run in and make sure they're ready. And then after that, guess what? The SRAM musical station is back, and they're going to give us a little musical interlude for your, I love this word, a little musical interlude for your edification. That would be
something that makes you feel good.
Oh, great. And then, believe it or not, we have the legendary. You know him, you love him. The young people at Future Scoop. Their fine presentation, an all-inclusive audio drama just for you. Then, guess what? By popular demand, he's back. Or I just say they're back. Johnny is gonna come with another special guest star, not Humpty Dumpty this time, but it will remain a secret. You will see when that happens, right after SRAM Musical Station. Guess who's gonna be? Johnny's like, big secret.
Oh yeah, I see that. Oh boy, it'll be a surprise, let me tell you.
Big surprise. And then we're gonna have, yes, you know him, you love him, you wanna hear about him, or hear from them. Yes, the Auroville Theater School, they've been working diligently. They've been just doing their thing. See, you're applauding for them already. I can't believe. Then, the people who's actually filming all this, the Yatra,
Foundation.
Come over. We just call them the Orison Group, but you can call them whatever you want. All right, what time we have right now?
Okay, it's 3:45.
It's 3:45. Get ready, hold on. I'll be right back, a little technical stuff worked out, and then we'll be right back. The technicians are working. I gotta get the new school is here. You all ready? You almost ready? Okay, we'll be right with you. In a bit, hold your horses and cows and pigs and peacocks.
Maya.
No, Johnny. Don't.
Injured.
The ubiquitous all-purpose tool, the Mumpty. I would like to introduce Humpty Dumpty. Now Humpty Dumpty had a Mumpty. He learned about it in school. He was confused how it was used. He thought it was a tool of a useless fool. He didn't see it for a symbol. The simple things and the humble things we mumble when we fumble with matter that can shatter and crumble until we feel like a fool. And what we need is a tool like Humpty's Mumpty. A tool with girth. With girth to give birth to the mirth and the earth. To engage in disarming the ancient secrets of farming where the man works the land with the sand in his hand. To plant a seed that he needs. A goo that he grew when he knew what the Mumpty could do. While digging one day, a voice in Humpty said, "Hey, there must be an easier way. Something more simple and clean." So he sat himself down, he designed a machine It was clunky and loud at first. I did a funky burst in an oily cloud, but as it got bigger, his big hole digger, it fattened his figure and made him feel proud. The fact of the matter was he had to add in the factor that he was now a contractor. When his wife started to act up, he up and he sacked her. He took his kids into leasing. And I turned a blind eye to hearsay and ended up living alone with his mobile phone. One night while watching TV in his JCB, Humpty Dumpty had a divine revelation. He tried changing the station. It was the same information. A blinding white light, clear out of the night. And the voice said, "Wake up, Humpty Dumpty. This is no time for tea. This is testimony to the golden Humpty." Now Humpty now knew what he could and couldn't do. He took out his lungi and tundu. He burst his bubble of boredom. Got his rusty bicycle from the storeroom. Took his kids out of Clooney. Gave him and got back on with his real life. Thank you.
Put something on while we clear.
That's funny.
Our musical station presents a soundscape, the Stampede. Wasn't that lovely? Let me take this opportunity to say this whole AudioDrama Conclave is to support the Auroville Radio, community radio station. And so this stuff is going to be edited and put on the radio sooner or later. Next, if I could have the New Creation School take your places, come on up. New Creation School, you're on. Come on, y'all know what you want to do.
Il était une fois trois petits cochons. Un grand frère, un moyen frère, un petit frère. Grand frère, elle allait pour construire son maison avec du briques. Un moyen frère, elle allait faire du maison avec du bois. Un petit frère, elle allait faire du maison avec du paille. Quand deux petits frères, elle a fini de faire son maison, elle allait jouer. Et le grand frère, quand elle a fini de faire son maison, elle a fait du piano. Derrière du arbre, un renard est venu. Et le petit frère, deux petits frères, elle n'a pas regardé le renard. Et quand le renard est venu pour attraper deux petits frères. Petit frère, elle allait sur son maison. Quand le renard est soufflé, la maison elle a dégonflé. Et le petit frère, elle allait à la maison de son moyen frère. Et quand le renard avait fait un coup de pied, la maison est cassée. Deux frères allaient à la maison de son grand frère. Et le grand frère a fait du violon. Le renard a d'aller et a monté sur la maison. Elle a sauté. Et le deux cochons, elle a mis une vase avec et le renard est allé sur la rivière et le trois renards, trois cochons l'étaient jouvés. Fini.
Okay, the Scram boys can take their places. We have a little music to listen for you for your. What did Johnny? What did Jesse say? For your. No, I said edification. He said
listening pleasure.
Listening pleasure. Listening pleasure. Yeah. Okay,
thank you.
Future school, get ready.
Yes, that's great. As I was saying, you know, the Swear Musical Station, they make their own instruments, which means you can go up there and buy the instruments they make. I purchased mine, but my instruments that I bought, the instruments I bought are not here yet. They're here?
Yeah.
I can have them before I want to see them, because that's like saying it's in the mail or something like that. And of course, as you realize, the new creation, they actually perform in French. Now, just put it on the side again. Cool. I believe you now that I see the bag. Is that my bag too? Did I get the bag? I get the bag too? No? I don't get the bag? Thanks. Okay. Are we ready? Oh, good. Hold on. You just can't have politics and you can't make no money. Okay? But anything else, you know, you want to get your message out there, your good, clean, fun message out there, then you can do that. So that's why we're here supporting Auroville Radio. And we can't do anything because we want to record this and put it on the radio. See, what's going to happen? What's going to happen is all the stuff that we're doing, they're going to take it and put it in what they're going to do some magic with it, add some more effects to it, and make it sound really, really good. We can, no? What changed? We don't need this one over here. Take that one. Ah. How you say? Okay, ready? How say again? What are we to do? We're good. We can start. Yay!
Hi, this is Eleni, and I'll be playing, I think, the captain.
Hi, my name is Lisa. I'll be playing Sheila.
Hi, my name is Aubert, and I will play Jean Picasso Worthing.
Hi, I'm Vinay, and I'll be playing the DJ Raga.
Hi, I'm Ashwin, and I'll be playing Pedro.
Hello, I'm Anthony. I'll be playing Ashinka, and I just want to remind all the students not to talk right into the microphone. Just, it'll be all right. They'll control it from there. Thank you very much.
I'll be playing, can you hear me? Veniska, all right. Our story begins in a nightclub on a cruise ship. In a nightclub on a cruise ship. The captain is saying something.
What's the problem, dude?
What do you think you're doing? I'm the captain, and dude is not really respectful to a mister.
Yo, lady, who the hell do you think you say you were? I'm a busy DJ, and what is your problem?
Hey, mister, the happy music is really turning me off.
Oh, yo. Do you know who I am? I mean, you're messing with the best of the best of the best. DJ Raga.
Hey, hey, come here.
There's a little problem, so please be silent. We're having some technical problems. Bear with us, please.
Hey, people, please. Stay.
Please go on with the music, otherwise you'll be eaten by the crowd. I was joking about the use of the language. Look, I'm also gonna dance now.
Scene 2. Looks like you are right, Aishinka. There they are, in the corner, acting like love birds. Birds who don't pay for their purchases.
Well, you know what is said. Birds of a feather
fly flock
together.
Looks like we're here a little early, Miss Microcorazon Chesa.
I just love the way you say my name, Pedro. And you speak English so well.
Pardon, Michelle. Did I not mention my university?
Sorry for interruption.
Yes, may we help you?
Do you know who we are?
Sure, you are the twins who work at the ship's store.
Correct, very right.
What's this about?
We don't mean to be bothered. The case.
But not in this case, no. We don't know who to be.
Oh. I guess you can put it on my bill.
No, you can put it on my bill.
It's fine, I insist. I come from a chivalrous culture.
And I come from Australia.
Please, don't argue.
Lovers should not argue.
We're not lovers, just friends.
Just friends for now.
Lovers?
Friends?
All the same in Kazakhstan.
No matter, you act like lovers.
Or friends who are lovers.
Pocket bill.
Can we split it down the middle?
Scene 3.
So know about fortune telling, yet now Jean Picasso waffling at your service.
Oh, I'm so happy. There's one thing I want to know. Do you know Pedro?
Oh, sure.
Says my name.
Oh, and the way he looks at you, the way he moves his lips, the way he wears a tie, the way he styles his
hair. Okay, but I want to know if he has feelings for me. Tell me, do I have a chance?
Oh, all right. I will tell you. There's nothing you want to become, there's only what you will become.
Scene 4.
This is the last day of our journey as we're reaching to our destination. Tomorrow, we'll reach Manhattan Island. So tonight is our last night together. So what are we waiting for? Let's party! DJ Raga, I don't know what to say. I'm so surprised. I mean, after what you said.
You love me? Oh my god, I can't believe it. But you're right, since the moment I first saw you in the club, I knew you were the one for me. Oh baby, kiss me.
Easy.
Oh, that's so sweet. But what about me? I have no home.
I'm here for you, baby. Just say the word.
You mean?
You like you, yeah, of course I do it.
Oh, this is great. I was just looking for the perfect man.
So, DJ Raga, you got something to say to me or is it goodbye?
Can I go to the toilet now, please?
No, you damn ass. You stay right there and tell me what's...
I really, truly love you and to prove it, here's a song for the girl of my dreams.
I'm one of the students in Modern Culture Center.
I am Anand. I am doing exercise.
I am Susan. I am working in the village.
I am Prakash from Sandinagar. I am working in Chorum.
I'm making baboon smash.
Hi, I am Rajesh. I'm going to school in Auroville.
Hello, I'm Anthony, and I live and work in Cape Town, South Africa.
Hello, I'm Aurelio. I'm looking for an umbrella.
Hello, I'm Paco, and I'm playing guitar.
I'm Paulo, we're from Sorum. We're going to present the Drops of Life.
Superman, stronger than our five wild animals roped together, more powerful than a speeding locomotive able to leap 10 Mutchmandias in a single bound, can stop bullets with his eyeball. Yes, Superman, more invincible and incredible than you ever imagined. Superman has heard that his secret love, Lois Lane, has been kept captive by the evil Lex Luthor.
That's me. I'm ready to go. I've got